Bach's contribution to music is so great, and also to other composers, that I feel it permeates Western music on so many levels, because it's not counterpoint for its own sake. It's really the beginning of music that's cohesive, that every note is related to every other note. And not in an academic way. The music is so joyful, and there's so much else to it, the rhythms, the buoyancy, the spirituality, that it affects all of the music that was written after. The French Suites are great Bach, Bach on the highest level. And Bach on the highest level could be approached by children, but nevertheless, the ideas are quite profound. There wasn't, I think, a note that Bach did that didn't have wider meanings and that wasn't in some way to be tackled with all one's heart and all one's soul. I find the first three, they're in the minor keys, they're very sad in some tender way. The sarabands are very touching. Then you get to the major keys, and they're very joyful. They're very gleeful. In fact, the fifth one, which is the most well-known, has that last da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. That's pure joy. The French suites are different, first of all, from the partitas and from the English suites in that they're more delicate. And very often it's a three-part texture or even a two-part texture similar to the inventions. So I would say altogether it's a more tender, more delicate area, the French suites. It's certain patterns, for instance, with the sarabands accenting the second beat is a typical French mannerism, let's say. And the type of ornamentation, and I think the type of feel. You could feel the influence of the French composers on Bach. I think dance rhythms are very essential. They're the sort of life spring of suites of the music which would bear their name. Now, just to pay attention to the dance element would be as wrong as not paying attention to it, because there's so much else. For me, the voice leading, the harmony, the counterpoint is really the most interesting aspect. But if you don't have a rhythm to somehow bounce this off, it becomes deadly. I myself do all the repeats because, first of all, they're small movements, they're not very long. And I think it's very nice when the repeat comes to vary it a bit and so do ornaments and add notes and things like that. I do a lot of that. And every time I would do something a little bit different to, I don't know, make it more imaginative than just playing the notes. I have performed the French suites much of my life. The fifth, in fact, was, I think, the first major piece of Bach that my teacher gave me. So I knew that from childhood, really. I think I was about 7 when I started that. And all of the others I knew in some way. I don't think I've played them in concert until recently. I play all the music that I record, I play it in concert. And in my own life, Bach meant a lot to me because there was a period when I couldn't play. And so I had to spend a long time away from the piano, but because I loved music so much, I had to be in music. And the solace and the consolation that I got was from Bach, which I would study Bach every day, and it would really nourish me. And so for that, I'm very, very grateful.